Members on the Parliamentary Forum on Children Affairs argued that the digital environment has become complex and toxic for children, exposing them to a spectrum of risks of online exploitation and abuse in various ways, including child pornography, online grooming, cyberstalking, cyberbullying, and exposure to harmful and inappropriate content.
We all know that internet, the information is there and there is no control in most cases. And so our children are open to all those risks. When we do not control what goes out, then we are bound to lose the younger generation because of the digital era.
I want to implore government to support initiatives towards establishment of child-friendly websites. These are things which are missing.
Margaret Makoka, the chairperson of Uganda Parliamentary Forum for Children, expressed concern over the excessive, unsafe and extreme content that is easily accessible to children of all ages. This attributes to internet and mobile penetration among children, which stands at 40% and 67% respectively.
Notwithstanding the existing laws on the protection and promotion of children's rights in the digital environment, there are still cases of cybercrime reported in the country. And according to the 2022 Uganda Police Annual Crime Report, a total of 286 cases of cybercrime were reported, implying that our children are still susceptible to greater risks of exposure to the digital environment.
Benjamin Waburoko, a child rights and child protection specialist at Save the Children, warned that the failure to invest, improve the safety and well-being of these children would be detrimental to Uganda's future.
Every actor in this country, starting with the duty bearers, and this is from the government, from parliament, have to play a role in ensuring that children in this country live free of abuse and the violence against children. And this is very well articulated in sustainable development goals, plus other legislations that the chairperson has been talking about.
He further cited the 2022 Annual Crimes Uganda Police Report, which highlighted that 258 cases of cybercrimes reported to police compared to 258 cases reported in 2021, arguing that the common child right violations on online platforms is getting worse every other day.
Available resources, and I'm talking about the budget. Yesterday we had the budget reading, and of course all of us must have got access to that. But we are only calling upon the state and the responsible organs and agencies to allocate appropriate resources to institutions that promote and protect children's rights. And we know that improved capacity of these institutions will enable tracking and follow-up of reported cases and durable solutions to the children that have been abused.
Legislators called for investment in research and gathering of data, noting that there is no concrete data on the number of children in Uganda, no data on school enrollment and dropout rates, yet such information is critical for policy formulation and planning.
And I want to share with all the Ugandans that is indeed very true that many of our children now use media in different ways. But our call to government and partners and the media is that the pornography must be regulated, because most of our children are getting destroyed out of the aspect of copying irrelevant characters from other countries.
These have relegated their responsibility. And they think that the teachers at school are the ones who are supposed to take care of the children. They also those ones who have dropped away from school. But the parents return home very late, so they do not have the time to educate their children and watch what they are consuming, even via the media, the digital platforms. So let us not relax. Let's be the gatekeepers.
In October 2022, President Museveni signed into law the Computer Misuse Amendment Act 2021, into law, making it illegal to share information about children. The act provides for a fine of 15 million shillings or imprisonment not exceeding 7 years, or both for anyone convicted. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.